tonight. Overwhelming. That's how hospitals are describing the COVID situation across the country and here at home.
Plus, it's been 1 year since vaccines became available, how we're doing, and what still needs to be done.
And looking for a getaway? Some new options are taking flight from a local airport.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 6.
Welcome to the CBS 3 News at 6. We're taking a live look at the Tom Rukavina Bridge in Virginia on this Thursday evening. After the storm, drivers across the region have been dealing with both icy and snow-covered roads.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke.
And I'm Briggs LeSavage. Thanks for joining us.
Last night's storm brought in cooler temps all across our region. Our meteorologist Dave Anderson joins us now. Dave, how long are these cooler temps sticking around?
Cooler temps probably all week, so the warmth of yesterday has gone and will be just a memory. We're not talking about really bitterly cold, but just a few degrees cooler than normal. Now, let's talk about last night's storm system. It was a big one. Came in with warm temperatures and then exited with the cooler ones here today. In just the last couple of seconds, I see that the winter weather advisory for Bayfield County that was supposed to stay in effect till 6 p.m. has indeed been let go. So the storm system is leaving, though it is still kicking up a gale warning for the time being over Lake Superior. Not a great night to go boating, just in case you had a hankering to do that. Towards Ontonagon County in the UP, that's a lakeshore flood advisory because of the big winds from the gale warning are making things a bit wet on the shoreline. So be careful there. Don't go and take a look at it, I guess. Just stay farther inland. Road conditions from last night's rain and snow still degraded a bit. A lot of slippery stretches marked off in the blue for Minnesota and Wisconsin, and for the range and towards the snow belt, still completely covered there, so do drive cautiously if you have a run to do overnight tonight. Overnight tonight will be getting clearer and cooler with lows around 5 above here, for example, in the Twin Ports. Friday's high temp 18, that's cooler than normal. Sunshine during the day could give way to another snow chance Friday night. We'll talk about if it's just a lot or a little coming up in a few more minutes.
All right, thank you, Dave. While last night's storm did not cause destruction in the Northland, it did do some serious damage south of us. That includes in Stanley, Wisconsin, in far eastern Chippewa County, where there was a confirmed tornado. Crews were out cleaning up this morning. Thankfully, no one was seriously hurt. But according to our sister station in Eau Claire, 15 to 20 homes reported damage. Most Stanley residents are still without power tonight.
And in Taylor County, Wisconsin, this man lost an entire building on his property. And you can see what's left of the shop in this video. Matt Bunkelman hunkered down last night while the storm moved through, and this morning was shocked to find the roof of his shop laying a quarter mile away. Wow.
And over in Minnesota, an Olmsted County man died when a tree fell on him. It happened last night when severe weather hit the Rochester area. The tree hit 65-year-old Keith Dickman in the head, and he later died at the hospital. Well, today marks an historic moment for Minnesota.
1 year ago today, Minnesotans could get their first dose of the COVID-19 vaccine. To commemorate this massive moment in the fight against COVID, Minnesota health leaders took time to reflect how far the state has come since the start of the pandemic. In a year, more than 8 million doses of the vaccine have been administered. More than 3 million Minnesotans are fully vaccinated. The Minnesota Department of Health Commissioner reminded people there's still light at the end of the tunnel, but with ever-changing variants, it's a little farther than they predicted.
We keep getting new challenges. The virus keeps changing and presenting us with new unknowns, and I know how tiring and frustrating that is for no one more than the healthcare workers and public health workers who've literally been working day in and day out for 2 years now to keep us all safe.
Malcolm says 25% of Minnesota children ages 5 through 11 have been vaccinated within 1 month of eligibility.
Meanwhile, here in the Northland, nearly every county in the region has more than 55% of its residents vaccinated. CBS 3's Quinn Gorham takes a look back on the last year and what health experts say still needs to be done to stop the spread.
Kelly Chandler with Itasca County Public Health remembers the excitement and optimism in the air when the first doses of the COVID-19 vaccine became available to health care and some other essential workers almost a year ago.
That first day, there was so much hope and so much positivity and joy in our office. It's a day I will not forget.
Since then, almost 293,000 people across the Northland, including those in Minnesota, Wisconsin, and Gogebic County in Michigan, have started the vaccine series, almost 64% of the region's population.
We've had very decent access to vaccines. We still do now.
Grace Grenager with Cook County Public Health says they've had huge success with the vaccine in their county, something she attributes to hardworking community members.
We have a very limited number of vaccinators, so we've all really had to work together and try to coordinate things for the community. So to the extent that we can support one another, we've really tried to support one another.
To date, Cook County has the highest vaccination rate in the state of Minnesota, with 83.4% of its residents vaccinated so far. They've had 325 cases of COVID throughout the pandemic and one death. Grenager says that's due in part to good education efforts within the community.
In the beginning, there's just this large volume of people wanting vaccinations, so we have to really work through that. And then as that slows down, we're able to put more time and energy towards outreach, education.
But despite that, Chandler says there's still a long way to go.
Making it so if there are some folks getting sick that it doesn't necessarily overwhelm our hospitals and clinics, that would be an important milestone for us.
Both Chandler and Grenager say they've recently seen a new rush in people looking to get their booster doses. You can find the latest information on COVID-19 vaccines in your area on our website. And we learned today the Duluth COVID testing site will add a couple extra days around the holidays. It's part of a statewide push to stop the spread as people gather with family and friends in the coming weeks. The testing site at the DEC will now be open both Monday, December 20th and Monday, December 27th. They're typically closed on Mondays. They'll be back to regular hours starting January 3rd.
After 20 days in a Duluth hospital, a Western Minnesota police officer lost his battle with COVID. Officer Ron Smith died at St. Luke's yesterday. The 58-year-old was from Browerville, which is southwest of Brainerd. He was first admitted to a hospital near his hometown in late November, but was quickly transferred to Duluth when he got worse. Smith worked in law enforcement in Western Minnesota for 14 years. Today, Duluth police officers led a procession outside St. Luke's, helping escort Smith's body back home. According to his obituary, Smith's funeral service will be held in Motley next Tuesday. Coming up tonight at 10, we'll hear from those who worked closely with Smith as they explain why he was such a great example for officers all across the state.
And Smith's death is a sobering reminder of the extreme toll that COVID continues to take on our family, friends, and hospital workers.
CBS3's Rob Cole spoke with the doctor at St. Luke's today about the serious overwhelm they're still facing as we head into the holiday season.
St. Luke's leaders told me today that there are virtually no more available ICU beds, and the system is about to be even more overwhelmed. Officials at St. Luke's say they are routinely treating patients who are transferred to Duluth from smaller rural hospitals. The reason for the transfer, patients need ICU-level care with a ventilator, but many rural hospitals don't have the staff to accommodate that many patients at a time. They say it's not just the amount of COVID and non-COVID patients in the ICU that's breaking the system, it's the length of time they're usually required to spend in intensive care.
If you recover, you do not recover quickly. It's a prolonged intubation, which is what is overwhelming the hospital system, you know, because as more and more people get sick, people are already filling up all the ventilators. There aren't enough ventilators to go around.
Lund says on average, once a COVID patient requires a ventilator, they're usually in the ICU for 2 to 4 weeks. She says right now, none of the patients in the ICU are vaccinated against COVID. Lund says the vaccine may not entirely stop a patient from getting the virus, but it can make COVID symptoms more mild and keep people out of the ICU and off ventilators. Lund says in addition to taking in patients from smaller hospitals across Minnesota, they're also seeing patients coming to St. Luke's from out of state. And as we mentioned, Officer Smith was unfortunately one of those patients.
Thank you, Rob. And tonight at 10, we'll hear from Officer Smith's police chief and what he meant to the community he served.
A Duluth middle school is investigating after several students received a picture of guns on social media. The Ordean East students say the photo didn't include a message and it came from an unknown person's account. Duluth public school leaders say there is no specific threat against the school or students, but the school resource office is looking into it. Superintendent John Magus says they take the matter very seriously.
We take every threat as a credible threat, and that even though there wasn't a threatening message linked to the account, but I can understand how some people would perceive the image of firearms to be threatening.
Duluth Public School leaders encouraged parents to monitor their kids' social media accounts. They also pointed to some helpful online resources explaining how to spot a possible threat. We've linked those on our website.
The prosecution rested its case in the Kim Potter trial today. Potter, a former Brooklyn Center police officer, fatally shot Dante Wright during a traffic stop earlier this year. She claimed she thought she grabbed her taser and not her gun. Prosecutors called more than two dozen witnesses, including a policing expert. He testified deadly force was not justified during the stop and using a taser would have been unreasonable. Meanwhile, the defense called a law enforcement expert as its first witness today. The expert said Potter's use of a taser was consistent with police training and practices. She is expected to testify.
Still to come on Live Local, CBS 3, pack your bags and get ready to leave the cold weather. How you could be heading to Fort Myers or Phoenix on a minute's notice next.
Today's high temp was 49 degrees. That happened just after midnight. Got pretty close to the record of 50, but temperatures have been going down ever since, and they'll stay down for the week ahead. Will that induce any snow chances? Well, maybe one in the next 7 days, and I'll tell you when this next go-around could arrive coming up after our break.
Get your news on the go, the CBS 3 mobile app.
Mom, I'm here. Mom, where are you?
Help.
Mom?
Without emergency protection, you risk your life. But with Life Alert, one press of a button can get you help fast. For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-458-9565. That's 1-800-458-9565. Call now, 1-800-458-9565. For a free brochure, call 1-800-458-9565. Injured? Call Stockman Law Office. Auto collisions, work injuries, all injuries. Call anytime, 218-576-8599. Free consultation, no recovery, no fee. Stockman Law Office. Serious injuries, serious law.
I'm telling you, you should open a business.
I wouldn't know where to begin.
I've got an idea.
I hope you like it.
I love it. Just one question.
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
It's a chair. New plan. You make the furniture, I make the ideas, NBC makes them happen.
That was always the plan.
Bring us your best ideas. National Bank of Commerce. We make more possible.
Menards has the tools you need to complete your projects. Stocked and ready to go. Known for innovative designs and affordable prices, Works provides the power and ease you need to get the job done right. This 20-volt 2-in-1 brad nailer and stapler is a must-have tool for every household. It's perfect for nailing trim to a wall. Only $139.99 after rebate. Plus, give the perfect gift with the Menards gift card.
Warm season's greetings to you all from Menards.
Mining, it's a part of Minnesota's history that affects everyone in the Northland still to this day. From environmental issues to economics and so much more. Join me, Kristen Bakke, every Tuesday for Eye on Mining. A fair and unbiased report that answers the tough questions surrounding the world of mining.
Eye on Mining with Kristen Bakke. Tuesdays at 10, only on Live Local CBS 3. Brought to you by Range Regional Airport.
Cancer research requires bold and innovative thinking. You may be able to help science uncover the next breakthrough by sharing your patient data and unique experience with researchers. Join Stand Up To Cancer and count me in at standuptocancer.org/countmein.
Welcome to CBS Mornings.
Up next, stories you'll be talking about today.
That's a big deal.
People stop me on the street and say, I always learn something new every day when I watch your show.
This morning, we're going to begin with some good news.
You just put me in a good mood.
Just follow me. I'll lead the way.
There's always something new under the sun. CBS Mornings, weekdays on CBS.
CBS 3 News is brought to you by Fond du Lac Casino. CBS 3 Weather is brought to you by Lake Superior College. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, here's a look at the snow totals that came in from the Coco Roz subscribers here. That's folks that send in their snow and precip reports to the National Weather Service. As far as the rain went, it went from a half inch to even 2 inches last night. And then this morning, the snow came around, and it came around to the tune of 5.5 inches in Hurley for the snow belt of the South Shore. Chisholm on the Iron Range tried to rival that, at least in some neighborhoods, 4.5 inches. Beauvais came in with 4. Grand Marais came up with 4 as well. Iron Junction, just a hair less at 3 inches. Coleraine was in that mix. And so was Grand Rapids. Cotton, just to the south of the Iron Range, has only got about an inch. So a lot of our towns got a trace to an inch. Others for the ranges and for the snow belt did a little bit better. Coming around tomorrow night is another snow chance, and I'll talk about how much that one could deliver coming up after this look at the current conditions. 70% for our relative humidity. Westerly wind, 23 miles per hour, so that's still windy out there, but just not as windy as last night or this morning. Half as windy. We had gusts into the 40s and even low 50s last night, now low 20s. We're improving. Tomorrow should be a lot calmer. Air pressure coming back up as our low pressure system departs. 29.87 inches of mercury. Current temperatures, they're going down. We have 16 in Ironwood, 16 in Ashland, but only 14 in Superior, the rest of Wisconsin. For the most part in between, though, LaPointe is the warm spot at 18. Our Minnesota numbers have dipped into the single digits from the Iron Ranges towards borderland, but still 10 to 12 from Cloquet to Moose Lake. Odds are we're going to cool down even more tonight, though. A lot of towns will bottom out around 5 above in the Hibbing-Chisholm area, and perhaps even Buell going towards 5 below. So clearing and cooling usually happens behind a big low-pressure system. Well, that low-pressure system is departing, and so still got a deck of clouds holding onto a good portion of our area, but looking at the local Doppler here, you can see some clearing from the west coming our way, and that'll aid in a bit, of course, the cooling as we go through tonight. Snow chances fading away fairly rapidly now as the low leaves, but our departing big monster storm from last night and this morning isn't the only game in town. There's another low off towards the west, a trough of lower pressure that brings back a light snow chance to us as early as tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, we could be seeing the snow kicking off about 4 in the afternoon to probably 4 in the morning or so on Saturday. Isn't a big deal. I think we're only going to get about an inch for most towns, maybe 2.5 towards the snow belt tonight. Minnesota low temps, cool, 5 below inland, 10 above by the lake. For Wisconsin and Michigan, 5 to 10 above for the range of lows there. Then we get into tomorrow during the daylight hours, partly sunny for our friends in Wisconsin and Michigan. High temps 20 to 22, that's just a little cooler than normal. 30% chance for the night snow Friday night into Saturday for folks in that part of our world. Well, on the Minnesota side of life, tomorrow's high temps will go from 13 inland to 20 by the lake, and it's a 40% chance for that light snow. Extended forecast, it tells us after the Friday night, Saturday morning chance for light snow, the snow chance goes away for the rest of the week. Temperatures, though, stay just a little bit cooler than normal, going about 18 to 24 for our highs, and overnight low temps, 2 to maybe 15.
All right, thanks, Dave. 2 new nonstop flights from Duluth International Airport take off for the first time tomorrow. Sun Country begins service from DLH Airport to Phoenix and Fort Myers. Flights are available Mondays and Fridays. Airport reps say there's a demand for more flights, especially to warmer destinations. Officials hope this expansion will help the airport recover from the pandemic financially. And to celebrate the new flights, the airport is hosting Pack Your Bags and Go. The public is invited to literally pack their bags and enjoy food and drinks at the airport from 5 to 7 Friday night. Attendees could win one of two travel packages to either Fort Myers or Phoenix. That includes airfare and accommodations for two travelers. Winners will depart that night and return to Duluth on Monday.
Kristen, I don't know if you're busy tomorrow, but I think we have some plans. Well, meanwhile, the DNR is asking people to weigh in on the proposed reroute of Enbridge's Line 5 pipeline. The oil company is moving the pipeline after the Bad River Band said they wanted it rerouted off their tribal lands. Enbridge is now applying for permits to build the proposed 41-mile route through Ashland, Bayfield, and Iron counties. It would impact about 135 acres of wetland and across about 185 waterways. The DNR will hold a virtual hearing on February 2nd. You can also mail in your comments, and those are due by March 4th.
Well, Duncan joins us now. Duncan, what's going on in sports tonight?
Well, we got a busy night. A new rule in women's college hockey might help the Dawgs get into the NCAA tournament. Plus, Dalvin Cook is reeling in some hardware and praising a Duluth native for helping him get there.
If you love them enough to crawl into a play place to get them to come down, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
CBS 3 Live Cams, brought to you by KohlerChev.com. Now featuring the Kohler Express Deal online buying solution. KohlerChev.com, a better way to buy.
I'm Dr. Kenji Sudo.
I'm Dr. Shane Maxwell, orthopedics and sports medicine physicians at Essentia Health.
And team physicians for the St. Scholastic Saints. At Essentia Health, we provide outstanding care for St. Scholastic student athletes whenever they need us, before, during, and after practices and games.
Essentia Health is proud to provide expert orthopedics and sports medicine care for Saints athletics and more than 25,000 student athletes in our community.
Make it the best holiday ever with the True Love Guarantee at Numi Jewelers. Dazzle her with a gift she's guaranteed to love. We're so sure she'll love the gift you choose that we'll even exchange it if she doesn't. True love is guaranteed at Numi Jewelers.
Our hearty and homestyle menu is back, starting at just $8.99. Enjoy our classic pot roast dinner, pot roast stroganoff, fajita breakfast quesadilla, and more. And treat the family to a delicious fresh-baked pie from Perkins Holiday Bake Shop. Take one home or order online at perkinstogo.com.
Calling all Bulldogs. Do you consider yourself a diehard UMD Bulldog fan? Send a picture of you or you and your crew all decked out in your Bulldog attire for a chance to be the My Nine Sports Bulldog Fan of the Week. Follow the My Nine Sports Facebook page and post your pictures there to be entered into our weekly random drawings. Each Fan of the Week will be showcased in our My Nine Sports UMD Athletics Broadcast of the Week. The My Nine Sports Bulldog Fan of the Week is brought to you by the Duluth Tap Exchange.
Okay, Dad. One, two, three. You saved me. Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
Heart attacks and strokes happen, even in the midst of COVID-19. And at least one will occur while you're watching this. Heart attacks and strokes are medical emergencies. If you experience symptoms of a heart attack or stroke, do not delay seeking care. Call 911 immediately. Hospitals are prepared and can safely treat you. Visit cdc.gov/coronavirus to learn more.
Local high school hockey lives right here on Thursday Night Faceoff. Whether you're looking for scores, game-winning plays, or more, tune to CBS 3. Thursday Night Faceoff with Duncan Goldberg and Kevin Moore, brought to you by Essentia Health.
The NCAA Division I men's hockey tournament has a field of 16 teams. The women's hockey tournament has historically included just 8 teams. That is until now. The NCAA has announced that they'll be expanding the women's tournament by 3 teams to 11. They've also approved a new format for the tournament. The top 5 seeds will get first round byes before the quarterfinals. That keeps their schedule relatively intact. The logic behind an 11-team field is to include the same percentage of all total women's hockey teams in the national tournament that the men's tournament has as well. And fresh off a bronze medal in their last world championships, the U.S. women's curling team eyes gold in Beijing. After finishing 8th in the Olympic Games in Pyeongchang in 2018, Team Peterson is returning most of their athletes and have major confidence going into this winter's Olympics. Confidence that hopefully fuels the U.S. women to bring home a medal for the first time.
We have high expectations. You know, where we're ranked in the world right now, and looking at all the other teams that'll be there, we've played against all these teams, we've beat all these teams.
we've lost to them too, but we've beat them. So just kind of having that, like we know what we're capable of. As long as we can kind of string it together a good week and focus on just our process, and it's just another tournament, and hopefully we'll come out with some hardware to bring home.
A week ago today, Dalvin Cook shocked Vikings fans and suited up for the Thursday night game against the Pittsburgh Steelers and put on an absolute show. Dalvin rushed for 205 yards and two touchdowns and 27 carries in the Vikings' 36-28 win over the Steelers, all while battling a major shoulder injury. And that performance earned Dalvin the NFL's FedEx Ground Player of the Week. But who would Dalvin be without the Duluth native in front of him, C.J. Ham, who has been blocking for Cook ever since he entered the league?
Yeah, you gotta love CJ. CJ is one of those guys that, you know, he just him, man. You know, you love that about him, that he's just CJ Ham. You know, he comes to work every day on time, you know what he need to do, his assignment. If you want to know something about running back, you can ask him. And he know both positions. You know, off the field, the things he do in the community is outstanding. You know, he's a dad. The things he do with his kids, you know, it's amazing. I look up to him as a big brother. So that's my guy right there. You know, you about to make me cry.
The Vikes are back on the field Monday night when they travel to Chicago, take on the Bears. And make sure you tune back in tonight at 10 for another edition of Thursday Night Faceoff. Even with the snowstorm, we still got a full slate of highlights from around the area. Plus, Minnesota Wild back in action after having their game on Monday postponed. All those highlights tonight at 10.
It's like a busy night for you, Duncan.
It will be.
All right. We'll talk to you later.
Well, a national ice skating show is
going to It's in the rink in Duluth this weekend. Stars on Ice is performing its holiday show at Amsoil Arena on Sunday. It's a tour across the country. Their last stop and the only show in Minnesota is right here in Duluth. Stars on Ice gives audience members the rare opportunity to see some of the world's most talented figure skaters performing together in both individual and ensemble routines.
This is really high-level skating, and it is not like watching it on TV. People don't get the sense of the speed they have to take to make those jumps, and I think people will be delighted to see what a thrilling sport it is.
Doors open at 3 o'clock Sunday afternoon. The show starts at 4 p.m. We have a link to buy tickets on our website. And coming up tonight at 10, we take you back in time before there was Stars on Ice and introduce you to a local ice volley, a Park Point resident at that.
Yes, so looking forward to that story. Dave, quick check of the weather before we go.
Tonight, clearing and cooling, low temps down towards zero for some towns. Then partial sunshine tomorrow before we get a chance for light snow Friday night into Saturday. That may add up to an inch. After that, it dries up and stays cool the rest of the week.
Thank you for joining us. We'll see you at 10.